For the topic today that I would like to share with you is about the topic that you might heard many, many times from the Buddha teaching, impermanence and suffering. Sometimes it come together. And also, if you look to yourself right now, right here, we are different more than yesterday, or we are look different more than in the past. And everyone in this room, we were like the children before, right? We were like the children before. So the time is move forward. That when we know about the topic impermanence, it means that we can see the beautiful thing in this world because we have limited time in this world. If we can live in this world many, many times, don't worry anything. But we have limited time. We live when one day we say goodbye to this world. So this thing we need to reflect and we need to take time to slow down and take a look together. For the topic today that I would like to discussion, just four things. Number one is suffering. Number two, impermanence. Number three, modern day. And the last one, number four, how to practice. Okay. When you see this term, suffering, it can relate with your experience. Dukkha or suffering. Dukkha in Pali term, or sometimes we call suffering, is a unsatisfactory experiences. Like you have experience with something that you don't like. Sometimes you like, sometimes you don't like. Sometimes you happy, sometimes you unhappy. Sometimes you feel good, sometimes you feel upset. Like the picture that I show about the cartoon that smile, then upset, unhappy. So it is easy to recognize, it is easy to observe, especially for your mood also, your emotion right now, right here. If you feel happy right now, please sign number one. If you feel upset or unhappy, please sign number two. And for this thing, dukkha or suffering, is unsatisfactory experiences. It means that everything isn't completely wonderful in our life. Sometimes we can accept that, oh, that anything is not perfect. Sometimes you can have this thing. Yeah, sometimes anything is not perfect. And if we have more expectation with something that you like to make it perfect, you feel suffer. And also, for the life also, sometimes you have a good day, have a nice day, and then along the day, throughout the whole day, you confront with the situation that make you feel bad, that make you feel upset. So for the one situation, it can change your entire life also. Like you confront with the experience that you never had before, or the experience that made you feel sad, or when you lost something that you love, you lost something that you have before, like the stuff. Or sometimes we lost our body, like the lost energy also. And from this thing, I love it so much. Life is impermanent. If you use the analogy, it's like the candle light. Did you know the candle light, right? So it just have limited time for this life. We never know about the last day that we gonna say goodbye this world. But we know only the birthday that we born and become like a human being. So everyone have the birthday, right? Happy birthday to you. So every birthday come, it means that you get older more than before. And for the candle life, sometimes we need to reflect about life, like the candle, how we can make the life shine and bright to yourself and bright and shine to the people around you. And also, when the candle light come, when you put the candle light, you put on the table, it can help you for eradicate the darkness around the surrounding around you. And also it can give the warm light. It can help you to feel warm. And also when the light is gone, the room will dark again. So the same thing. So that's why we need about a healthy body, oxygen, or sometimes you need inner peace. That's why we stay here today for practice meditation, learn about wisdom, and connect with your life. So life is impermanent. Keep in your mind. Sometimes we look ourselves, oh, we have more time to stay, but no one know about the last day. Maybe tomorrow, maybe next year, maybe in the future. But today we have the time. Just spending the time with something that matters for you. Just spending the time with something that important for you. Your friend, your relationship, your loved one. Because sometimes we cannot stay together again. And keep in your mind that today is a gift for your life. And then for this thing, contemplating impermanence, sometimes we need to know about the purpose for contemplating impermanence. Death and unsatisfactory experiences is not to become depressed and have the joy taken out of life. It's not about that. It's not about the purpose. And sometimes most of the people, when we think about this thing, we think about impermanent, we think about death, we think about unsatisfactory experience or unhappy. We feel depressed or feel not have joy in life. It's not the purpose for contemplating. So the purpose is about this thing. The purpose is to rid ourselves of attachment and false expectations. When you have attachment in life, the people, the stuff, animal, anything is gonna fade away. Anything is one day is gone, right? But if we bring our mind to connect with something that up and down, it can have the harmful to your mind, unhappiness will come. But if we use this thing or the purpose to get rid of ourselves of attachment, it means that you can have less stress, less worry, and more happy because you don't feel expectation with anything. When we have more expect, we need something to return, right? But if we have false expectation, so it can destroy your life also. But if we have correct expectation, it can helpful for you to live in a good life. And also for the attachment is a key to make you feel suffer. The people, the stuff, animal, the emotion, it up and down, it's not stable. So how we can make the mind to be calm and peaceful, make the mind to be stable, is about to practice meditation, practice mid and way. And then in the modern day, if you reflect back about your daily life or daily routine, right now we connect with the people, with the smartphone, with the social media, with the information with any platform that make you can live in the modern day. But sometimes our mind are easily overwhelmed by attachment. We see people and objects in an unrealistic way. It's not the realistic way, it's unrealistic way. Example, if you see the profile of the people that have in the social media, in the Facebook, maybe 10 years ago, 20 years ago, it not change it. Sometimes they use app like the to make up, to make the profile at the picture is look good. But when we see the real situation, oh, it differently. It's not the same at the picture that they post in the Facebook, something like that. So the same thing, or sometimes when we see the social media, we see the advertisement, oh, this thing is so good. Wow, they look good. They look happy. But is it the advertisement also? And also the people, the object, we see it in the modern day, like the unrealistic way, not in the realistic way. Sometimes we have the innate view that, oh, we just would like to stay younger forever. We would like to keep our loved one, not to be older. We would like to keep the thing that can stable all the time. It cannot, because the stuff, the people, the object, it have limited time. One day it's gone. When the time pass, it can destroy by itself. And when we look from the Buddha word, in the Buddha time, 2500 years ago, this is from Mahaparinirvana Sutta, that the Buddha said to the monk before he parinirvan or he will pass away, he said to bhikkhu, or remind to the bhikkhu, bhikkhu is mean the monk, I address you now. Transcend our conditioned things. Try to accomplish your aim with diligence. So from this thing, I think it's very clear and very useful, recommended by the Buddha. And he looked the world not pessimistic, but he looked the world at the realistic. He looked for the like the present moment. Transcend our conditioned things. It like everything is impermanent. The stuff, the people, especially for the Buddha, you see, one day is gone. 80 years old, so we can look back to yourself. One day we're gonna go on from this world also. One day we're gonna say goodbye to this world. Or sometimes we don't have time to say goodbye because we don't know about the future. We don't know about tomorrow. And he guided the way that, oh, try to accomplish your aim with diligence. It means that because time is limited, we just use time wisely. Aim with diligence with everything that you would like to accomplishment for the daily life, about the relationship with someone that we love, and don't be regret later because we do it the best for every single day. Something that you can share the good thing to the people, sometimes you can say love to them. Sometimes you can take care of someone that you love before you don't have time to take care. Sometimes you can call to someone that you would like to say love to them. So just use your time wisely. The time is not come back again. It like the asset that it have more value than the asset. Because if you have more money, you can buy any stuff, but you cannot buy time. Time is gone. If everyone have limited time and one day is gone. So use time wisely and diligent. And also from this line, how to practice. Number one, accept that our life will end. Number two, don't worry, do the best for today. Number three, practice meditation. For number one, accept that our life will end. So I think for the number one is the simple way to make you reflect that life one day it will end. We cannot live forever. We cannot stay young forever. And we need to prepare that, oh, every step about our life, we need to do the good thing. Yeah. Do the good thing, avoid bad, and purify the mind. Accept that our life will end, and everyone also, their life will be end also. When you accept, you see the world, you see the life in the realistic way. You see those things in the realistic way. So it makes you can like the be careful with every day that we live in this world. Be careful. Be strong. Be careful first, you know. Accept to be careful that, oh, life is limited. We can use time wisely. We can do something good for yourself, for your loved one, for your family, for everyone that come to your life. Because everyone have the last point or the last thing is about death. Yeah, just accept. Number two, don't worry. Do the best for today. If you worry so much about anything in your life, you cannot have time to do the best for today. If you worry so much about the past that already gone, and you worry about the future that not yet to come. So for the past that already gone, we cannot fix it. We cannot back the time to fix anything. It's gone already. It passed. And for the future also, it's not yet to come. But we worry so much. We cannot do the best for today. And it lies in the one person. It just have three person in your life. Number one is about the present, the person in the past. Number two is the person in the present. And number three, the present, the person in the future. So if we use three things come together, it like we hold something. Oh, very suffer. Yeah, it's very healthy, very healthy. It's too much. And also, if you release this, if you release, you practice let go, you keep only the present. When you do anything, just do it one thing at a one time. To connect yourself, connect with your body and your mind. So don't worry. Do the best for today. Everything that you can do the best, just do it. Speak good, do good, and make the time for every single day with the happiness, help people, share something that's good to someone that you love. And also, number three, practice meditation. Every time that you practice meditation, you can reflect about impermanent, especially for your emotion that up and down. And also, if we can control our mind in the stable way, like the Buddha said, peace of mind surpasses all kinds of happiness. If we would like to be happy every single day, we need to practice meditation. Stay in the present. Bring the body and bring the mind, stay together. And the teacher, my teacher just said, practice meditation just only two times. When you open your eyes, and when you close your eyes two times, it means throughout the whole day, we need to practice meditation. We need to practice mindfulness. And if you see about the Eightfold Noble Path, number seven and number eight. Number seven is about mindfulness. And number eight, right concentration. Number seven, right mindfulness. And number eight, right concentration. Right, when you go to outside, you can practice mindfulness. When you walk, when you lay down, when you jogging, when you exercise, when you do work, we can practice right mindfulness to open the eyes. And when you would like to have deep meditation, you can find a quiet place. The quiet place that can support your practice meditation, like the quiet room, far away from noise, far away from distraction, and take time to stay alone with yourself. To stay alone, to observe your feeling, observe your mind, observe your sensation, and maintain the stillness that the founding teacher of the Minimal Way, he said, stillness is the key to success. And also, the last thing I would like to share with you, be the lamp for your life. Because like the candlelight, right? When we have it together, we can share the light to the people around you. And then when we have more light, it can become like the good community that we practice together, that we do good thing together, that we sharing the good thing together. Thank you so much. Have a good day, everyone.